Amid an ongoing maritime dispute, the Philippines and China strengthen trade ties as they seek to establish a cooperation zone for economic development. Jackie Pascual reports.
Despite maritime tensions, China and the Philippines are beefing up economic and trade ties. Hundreds of delegates from Zhangzhou City in Fujian Province, China, are in Manila for an economic conference. Philippine Trade Secretary Alfredo Pascual welcomed the business delegates as he said both sides can take advantage of the momentum brought by the Regional Comprehensive Economic Partnership, which took into force in the Philippines just last month.
We are encouraging Chinese businesses from Zhangzhou to continue their engagement and explore business opportunities in the Philippines.
China's ambassador to the Philippines, Wang Silian, also highlighted the growing trade relations of the two countries.
Our bilateral trade reached $87.73 billion. China has been the Philippines' largest trading partner for 7 consecutive years.
While the maritime dispute was not mentioned, the two officials signified their intent to improve relations of the two nations.
The next 5 years will be very crucial for China's development agenda.
I would like to assure our Chinese counterpart that the Philippine government has the support for your investors. Remember that China and the Philippines share a rich history and a vibrant cultural connection.
The conference aims to create a cooperation zone for economic innovative development between Manila and Zhangzhou, where they could explore investments in various areas, energy and cold storage. Jackie Pascual, ABS-CBN News.
The government formally launches green lanes for strategic investments in a bid to attract more foreign investments. The launch came months after President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. signed Executive Order No. 18, which mandated the establishment of green lanes in national government agencies and LGUs. The move aims to further raise the ease of doing business in the country by simplifying procedures and bureaucratic layers. Marcos also says the green lanes can help realize the investment pledges he secured during his overseas trips.
Let us take that load off the business sector and take it on, because that is the role of government, is to handle all these bureaucratic procedures, not so that we delay and we open opportunities for corruption, for wastage.
Here's some stocks to watch out for. We're monitoring shares of Amazon. That's after the e-commerce giant reported day one sales of its Prime Day event rose nearly 6% compared to last year. Amazon shares are up 1% in pre-market trade. Also in focus, shares of Delta. The American carrier posted its highest quarterly revenue and earnings ever, thanks to a travel boom. The news sent Delta shares soaring nearly 4% before the bell. We're also keeping a close watch on PepsiCo shares after its quarterly earnings and revenue topped analysts' expectations. It also raised its full-year outlook. PepsiCo shares are up nearly 3% in pre-market trade.
Markets first, they're joining the global rally on the back of news U.S. inflation cooled to a more than two-year low. The German DAX is up more than 0.5%. London's FTSE 100 also higher. Investors there reacting to data that showed Britain's GDP shrank 0.1% in May, which is actually better than the 0.3% contraction that was forecast. As for oil prices, they are flat but on the upside. Global oil prices climbed Thursday following the U.S. inflation data. A report from the International Energy Agency, meanwhile, said demand is set to hit a record high this year. Still, it lowered its demand forecast for the first time, citing persistent economic headwinds. As for futures on Wall Street, they're up. Investors now turning their focus on the producer price index. The key inflation gauge will provide further clues on the Fed's next move.
Here are some local corporate headlines. Security Bank issues 18.5 billion pesos in corporate bonds, its largest issue to date. The bonds carry a rate of 6.4% per annum and a tenor of 1.5 years. The bank shares ended Thursday trade 1.7% higher. Beverage kiosk giant Frutas aims for a revenue growth of 30% as it plans to open 50 new stores in the first half of the year. It also seeks to open up to 5 new brands and 50 more stores for the remainder of the year. Futa shares close up 1.8%. Meanwhile, Megawide got shareholders' approval to acquire TH1 World Developers from its parent company, Citicor Holdings Investments, for over 5 billion pesos. This will place the engineering firm in the affordable housing market. Megawide shares close higher by 1.5%. And Alternergy bags 3 projects in the Philippine Energy Department's Green Energy Auction. These include wind projects in Quezon and Rizal provinces and a solar project in Tarlac. The energy company shares jumped 8.3% in today's trade.
Asian markets surged as cooling U.S. inflation bolstered hopes the Fed is done with its rate hiking cycle. The Hong Kong Hang Seng led gains, that's despite poor trade data from China, which showed exports contracted 12% in June, its fastest pace since the pandemic. Meanwhile, the South Korean KOSPI picked up 0.6% after the Bank of Korea held its benchmark interest rate unchanged for a 4th straight meeting. Some notable stock movements in the region. Chinese tech firm surged on reports Premier Li Qiang met with several companies Wednesday, further boosting hopes Beijing's years-long crackdown on the tech industry is over. Philippine shares joined the region-wide rally, jumping over 1%, with value turnover coming in at a healthy 6 billion pesos. But Dragonfly's Giancarlo Lim says in this kind of volatile environment, some listed firms might opt to go private.
A symptom of the larger issue that we've been talking about, like the illiquidity and the lack of participation, right? So every company really has to do its own calculus with regards to whether they want to stay publicly listed or go private. Are you a company that values access to capital? Do you want a higher profile associated with being a public company, or is the cost of compliance too onerous for your stage of development?